Oh, hi there. Welcome back to the second episode of Frostpunk. So, last time we left off by just getting the research for heaters in the workplace. So at least our medical building can continue to function because we have 5 people being treated and 4 are still sick. We are currently in the process of researching the beacon so that we can access the world map. And because our temperature has dropped significantly, we have reduced or literally just disabled the people from gathering resources here. So also for gathering resources, you have this building. And yeah, it has like a range. So if I build it here, then they can gather resources for all those buildings. And we can also heat this building, so it's less of a problem if those resources are being a bit cold. So let's first get a road, like roughly along this edge. I like the having the road spaced properly, and let's just build it. Let's just build it here, and then just make sure that the road's connected. Streets undergoing construction. Excellent. That's fine. Let's speed up the game a bit. So this will give me wood, and steel. So where is the? This is coal. There is some. Yeah, there are literally 2 coal places here. So I will also build a road along this axis. Yes, something like this, and then build another gathering post to gather the coal that is around this area. I still have this coal patch. Where are you going? Are you going in the snow? You're probably my hunters. I don't know how they get out of here. There looks to be some kind of a ladder here. I can rotate it. But it seems to be like collapsed. So yeah, I'm not sure how my hunters are going to hunt, but oh well. You can also see that we only have 21 hours of coal left. And that might be 24 hours before we increase our heat again. I did calculate that we would make it, but I didn't account for the heater, so yeah. Also, if I increase, yes, let's add people here. Definitely increase the working hours and turn the heater on. And also turn the heater on here and decrease the working hours. This will probably provide me with enough resources. How much coal? There is 1,000 coal left. It is 500 each, it seems. And how quickly do you gather? Might be displayed as soon as they are going to start working on it, which will be in about 1 hour due to my extended working hours. Yes, exactly. And they will gather about 16, 17 coal an hour. Oh, this will definitely keep everything nice and warm during this this cold wave. Workers needed. Yes, I could put the children to work, but I don't want to do it yet. I might save this. If I have plenty of hope, then I can do this. And if I have low hope, then I could use this to increase the hope. But for now, we're doing fine. I don't really need the workforce yet, so I'm just going to ignore the tips the game is giving me. Not that I'm saying that I know better than the game, obviously, but because this one is not really doing a lot, there is not a lot of raw food, so I can easily reduce the number of workers there and assign it to other buildings. Yes, we have the beacon. Pause the game, or at least let it run on a low speed. We can build this beacon around, I don't know, it doesn't, does it matter where we build it? No, I think that it doesn't matter if this is heated or not, so let's just build it right about. Oh, it will, oh, I'm not going to, I don't want you to destroy the wood that's there, so let's build you here. Just out of the way of my base, to give more space for buildings that I believe need heat more than this guy. Also, that means we can choose a new technology. So I think that faster gathering is nice, but I don't have enough wood, so I have to wait for 1 or 2 seconds. And yeah, there we go. So we can get rid of those piles of resources a bit quicker. And that's just nice, because we want to focus on not on the wreckage, but on the infinite sources, like these fallen trees. I'm not sure if the fallen trees are infinite, by the way, but there might be something that allows you to regrow trees or some stuff like that. I'm not 100% sure. Yes, you are not working because there is not enough raw food. That is perfectly fine. We are building this. Excellent. And how is my coal supply? We have about 21 hours of coal, but as soon as the temperature rises, I can at least turn off the heater for the medical building. And yeah, we will have to increase the next generator level. For example, this double the coal usage of the generator from 6 to 12. But if you have like a lot of buildings around it that use a heater to keep warm, then it's more efficient to just upgrade the generator. Let's see. I don't want to do heating yet. The beacon I have fixed. A coal thumper are the buildings that we can mine the underground deposits, and the sawmill and the steelworks as well. But I have plenty of resources lying around, so I will first go for hunter's gear just to get a bit more food. I don't mind having a surplus of food, although we can only store a certain amount, and if we increase it, then we need to build additional buildings. But is this finished? No, it's under construction. Oh yes, waiting for workers, but we don't have any available workers, so let's decrease the workers here. I believe that some might be able to build during the evening hours. I'm not 100% sure, or maybe if this building is disabled or something, but this will... I hope that you are going to be building this now, or I need to reduce some other building. Maybe just reduce 5 workers here. Let's see if you are going to build. Yes, there you go. Are you engineers? I don't know if you're an engineer. Maybe not. You have a cold home. Why? You have tents. The tents are heated, right? Oh, but it's still considered chilly because we are at minus 40 degrees. Okay. I must agree with you that minus 40 degrees is a bit chilly. So, but as you are building, I can increase the people for that building again. Just to get a bit more food. I like having enough food. You never know what's happening. Yes, the beacon has been built. And now we should float a giant air balloon, because why the hell not? But now I believe we can get random events for people that stumble across our place. Or we can access the world map. And I will hope that that's... Yes, exactly. We have the world map here. And there are things we can do. We need to have scouts, so we need to probably assign them somewhere. We can see people, yes, in the crash site. So yes, we need to have scouts, and that requires 5 workers. So if I decrease this building by 5, we can build a scout. It also requires wood. Maybe they need to build a sleigh or something. And we can either go to the crash site, that probably gives supplies, or Reiki can go to here, that probably gives people. As they said that I need to do this, I'm just going to send them to here. And it will take them a certain amount of time, 10 hours. And there might happen things with them while they are out and about. Maybe this is already something. Oh no, this is just that we finished that building. But yeah, there might happen some things to them. And they might get hurt, or they might find additional resources or something like that. So what else are we needing to be building? I will just make a small jump cut until we have reached this destination, so you can see how it looks. All right, welcome back. We just finished the Hunter's Gear research, and a couple of other things happened. So I wanted to start just before they arrive. The temperature has increased to 30 degrees. I also signed a law and built a care house that allows me to put people in there that are amputees or gravely ill, and they will consume a bit less food until we can do something for them. And they don't take up beds in our medical building, because we do have quite a lot of sick people, unfortunately. So our people has just arrived, and let's see, we need to explore, and then we find survivors, thank you. And we can either escort them to the city, which will be faster and they will be safe, or we can send them off themselves and they might die a few. But since we are really just this close, I'm going to send them back with my scouts, because I really, really, really want some additional people. Just to fill up a couple of buildings. So we're also out of research, so let's see what we can do. I probably want the next level of yeet to be researched, but it will cost 50 wood, so I guess we have to wait for that, because there is another temperature decrease incoming. So yeah. And if I am getting a bit more people, I might as well build another hunter's hut here, just to make sure they have enough places to live. Frightened patient, you don't want amputation. Yeah, you know what? If you don't want to be amputated, then who am I to say you must be amputated? Probably means he's going to die though, so. Well, if that's what you want, it's your choice, right? I don't really mind. Actually, I do really mind, because even if you are an amputee, you still... I thought they could work. This person has lost one of the limbs. They can't work until they receive prosthetics. Oh, I thought amputees did work, but with a reduced efficiency. But apparently the answer is no. And we just got our people for the first time. So fantastic. We got a hell of a lot of them. I too quickly closed the dialogue, so I don't really remember how many people it was. I believe it was like 23 workers and 9 engineers and 3 children or something like that. We should follow it to ask for more people. Yes. I'm also going to send the scouts immediately to the crash sites just to get a few resources. What is this? Yes, unfortunately he died. So, okay. Yes, we must make sacrifices to survive, even though you choose for yourself. I probably want a graveyard. We need to wait 20 hours until we sign a new law, so we just have to keep an eye on the cooldown here before we can do any fun about it. Now that we have the people, I will increase the people working here. And even though it's cold, I am desperately in the need of wood, because I want to do the research. And I now have 33 people that are homeless, so I am going to have to be building a couple of more tents. And keep in mind, these tents will definitely be cold. Let's build 2 here. I try to keep them in this inner range, because if I upgrade the generator, then this is the best place for them to be, because then I can extend the... Why can't I build a street? Oh, it costs wood to build a street. Oh well, there we go. Now I know why you shouldn't just spam streets. But I was saying, if I get the generator upgrade, then I can extend the range of the generator, so all these homes are getting heated. Yes, my care house is finished, so everybody that is ill here terminally ill will eat half rations, and I believe they don't get sad about that until we get to find something we can do for them. No workers available. Oh, we have 9 engineers but not workers, so apparently only engineers can work here. So let's put the engineers into here and put some workers into here, and then we get still 4 more engineers. Let's increase this gathering post, and here, no, this is full. Let's keep 2 to be able to build things. Let's just speed up time a bit until the next morning. And all right, it's morning again. So let's build this road now, right here. And this guy also wants some road, so let's build it like there. Street is under construction. We have arrived. We can explore and find wood and raw food. That sounds like fun. Take the resources. So we can now choose to continue to the next one. But we don't get the resources until we get them back. So we have to keep that in mind. Also, oh yeah, I needed 50 wood. Yeah, I should really just increase the, or just research before I build all those new homes. I also am definitely going to be needing to research the sawmill real soon. Maybe do that now, because wood is a bit of a problem. So let's get the sawmill start. Because if I run out of wood and I can't research the sawmill, then there is no way that we are being able to get wood again. So yeah. Also, I can put some people in there. I'm not sure how I... Oh, because this got mined out. That's why I got additional people. Excellent. Our research will the research will be done relatively quickly. I can also get another tent right here. It's not... how many people are living in? 10 are living in a tent. I thought we had more. So maybe I just cancel this for now. Cancel. Yeah. Ah, the laws. Yes. I want the cemetery. Yeah, each burial will keep people from work for 4 hours. No risk of disease. And bodies are preserved for potential future use. But the hope will fall and the discontent will... Let's go for the cemetery. Even though I have to build one. Let's build it all the way away from my base. I don't think it really matters. I don't think anyone is working there, really. And we can always build a heater. I think I'm going to build another medical post, because we really have a lot of sick people here. Where should I build it? It can heat itself, so I might build it here. Yeah, let's build it here. Because it can heat itself, if I increase the range, then I'd like to use this space for people. Now I can build a sawmill, but it will cost 10 wood. Am I going to get 10 wood today? Oh, no resources. Okay, so we have to dismantle this building. It will give me some additional wood, which is great, because I think this was the last bit of wood in the game, or at least freely available. So that means I was just in time. Hey, we found survivors. A bear. Ooh, the bear will kill the survivors or attack the bear. Yeah, of course I want to do that. Risk attacking the bears. People in the cave joined them. Unfortunately, the scouts died. Oh my god. Alright, that's unfortunate, because... Oh, you have my... No, you don't have my resources. So that means I lost the resources I just gathered. It was food and wood. Yeah, I would definitely liked to have the wood. But yeah, I think I'm just in time from being out of wood. So let's quickly go to the next day. Yeah, cemetery has been established. Great. Increase the people in the medical post. That's also a good idea. Nobody's working here, right? No, exactly. And now let's build a sawmill. And the sawmill really just gathers the stuff like here. So I might be able to build it. Let's see, I don't want to overlap the wood. Maybe this is a good place. And then build a small piece of street. So we do have to keep in mind that we always need some wood for the streets, because the buildings won't function if they're not attached to a street. Also, can I? Oh, we don't have any more additional engineers. So yeah. I want to build a new scout, but it requires 40 wood. So we're really in the need of wood right now. So I'm definitely going to increase the working hours as soon as possible here, just to get a bit more wood. Thank you very much. 24 people are also sick. Wow. Let's see if I can get a couple of engineers. Let's change you over so that there are engineers working there. And workers in here. 8 workers. I'd like to have more workers there. Can I reduce the amount of workers somewhere else? Yeah, let's just reduce them here again. There's still not enough food for that building to become really effective. Also, you seem to have mined everything, which is interesting. I really just have this place. Just send a couple of people there. So I'm really just going to make sure that I queue up all these resource gathering buildings, at least have one of each, so that they can work and that I always sure that I have at least some kind of resources. This building is also chilly, so there is a risk of them falling ill, so I might turn the heater on. It will cost a coal, but if I concentrate a few buildings around this area, maybe this coal depot for example, then I can build like one of those small heaters that I can research. And yeah, if I do that, then I save some coal. Do we need anything here? Funerals, loss of hope caused by death is halved. Oh yeah, that sounds fantastic. Thank you. Yeah, that's fine. 2100 hours, that's perfect, because that is at some other place. Heat homes, heat all the homes. You have to start heating one of the cold homes. Yeah, I want to heat it, but I don't really know when, to be honest. Let's say heat some homes, which are cold. You are probably cold, right? Yeah, chilly. Let's get the temperature overlay. Medical post is also chilly. Tent is chilly. Yeah, I just can't really heat them right now. I must upgrade my generator. And in order to do that, I will need 50 wood. I do have 50 wood now, so I can, as soon as this research is finished, I can do that. But I think that is something for the next episode. It's a quite long episode already, so I will just stop the recording here. And thank you all for watching. See you again next time. Bye bye.